This is Adam Martin with your Western District Fishing Report. Cool water temperatures have finally arrived at Kentucky and Barkley Lakes. As usual for this time of year, that means better catch rates of bass and crappie. Anglers are reporting good catches of largemouth bass on large topwater lures, and based on our electrofishing results, we're seeing bass concentrated on the woody structure and around docks in deeper water. The stake beds haven't been as productive as prior years so far, but it's always a good idea to check out the deepest stake bed in whatever bay you're fishing. The best lures for those structure-oriented bass have been jigs, crankbaits, with some anglers having success with creature baits or even drop-shot rigs cast with expert precision. The crappie bite has also improved, but the crappie seem to be staying unusually deep for this time of year. Try to concentrate around 10 to 20 feet of water, and don't get too focused on one area or even one technique. The willingness to change approaches has improved catches for some anglers. The best catches are coming from Lake Barkley, but the black crappie bite on Kentucky Lake is also picked up in Blood River and Jonathan Creek. With heavy rain and potential lake level changes in the forecast, we may see some unusual patterns for this fall, but only time will tell. Please remember to wear your life jackets and kill switches. Good luck and good fishing.
This is Justin with your Northeast Fishing Report. With these cooler temperatures, the musky bite at Cave Run should start turning on. At the time of this recording, they are still dropping the lake, which means fishing is a little bit harder. Try targeting deeper water than normal, or keep your eye on the lake level. Once it stops dropping, conditions should be great. We are also getting really good reports of nice largemouth bass being caught at Grayson Lake. One angler said that he was having good luck with white spinners and crankbaits. We also have a lot of trout fishing opportunities in the area. Over the past few weeks, parched corn and chimney top were stocked. These were smaller fish and intended to grow to larger sizes. Parched corn is under a catch and release regulation, and chimney top is under a 1 brown at 16 inches. Other areas that have been stocked and you're able to catch and harvest are Grayson Lake and Cave Run tailwaters, Big Caney and Laurel Creek. That should do it for us. Good luck and be safe out there.
This is Rob Rold in the Northwestern Fishery District with a fishing update for our area lakes. Rough River Lake and Nolin River Lake are both in the middle of their winter drawdown. They're both around 7 to 8 feet below summer pool, and they're falling somewhere in the neighborhood of 6 inches a day. Surface temps have been running low 60s up to mid 60s. And as the water temperatures cool down, bass and crappie fishing has really picked up over the last week or so. The bass at both lakes have been doing well. It seems like numbers are higher at Rough, but size is better at Nolin, so the anglers are catching fewer big fish at Nolin, but lots of good solid 15-inch plus fish at Rough. Crappie fishing has been excellent at both lakes, especially at Rough River Lake. Crappie have also been good at Lake Malone, as well as they've been catching some good ones out of the larger, deeper Peabody WMA pits. Of course, we have our Fins Lakes. Anglers are still catching some catfish in them. Next month, November, we'll start the trout stocking for the winter. So that's something to look forward to in the next couple of weeks or so. So that is an update from Northwestern Fishery District. Please remember, always be safe on the water, wear your life jackets, and that's especially important right now as these water temperatures are dropping because hypothermia can set in very quickly.